Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to verify a trig identity using the basic identities and the identity for the cosine of a sum or difference. So here's our problem. Cosine of x plus y over cosine of x minus y is equal to cotangent of y minus tangent of x over cotangent of y plus tangent of x. Right off the bat, make sure you do not try to cancel the cotangent y over cotangent y. Can't do that. Can't cancel the tan x's. Remember, only if it's factored can you do that. Similarly, cosine of x plus y is not cosine of x plus cosine of y. You have to use the identity. All right, so let's do this one by drawing a line. This is one way of doing a proof. And we're just going to simplify one side at a time. Or what we could do is a little bit of both. And I think in this case, it might be easier to start off with the definitions. I'm sorry, the identities for the cosine of x plus y and the cosine of x minus y on the left-hand side. So let's start there. So cosine of x plus y is cosine of x, cosine of y minus sine of x, sine of y, and the cosine of x minus y is cosine of x, cosine of y plus the sine of x, sine of y. Now at this point, it's kind of confusing to figure out what are you going to do from here. You can't factor out the numerator, you can't factor out the denominator. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the right side and try simplifying that a little bit. And the natural thing that comes to mind is to change the cotangents and tangents in terms of sines and cosines. So let's do that. The numerator here, cotangent of y is cosine of y over the sine of y minus, and the tangent of x is the sine of x over the cosine of x. Now in the denominator, we've got the cotangent of y plus the tangent of x. So it's going to look exactly the same as the numerator except a plus sign there. Cosine y over sine of y plus sine of x cosine x. So we have this complex fraction. Anytime I see a complex fraction, the first thing I want to do is get rid of the complex fraction by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the least common denominator, which in this case is cosine x times sine y. I can see I'm not going to really have enough room here, so I'm going to make everything just a little bit smaller here. So let's do that. All right, so here's what we have so far. I gave myself a little more room here so that I can rewrite this complex fraction by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the least common denominator. Looks like that little x got off. All right, so we're going to multiply it by the cosine x times the sine of y, because that's the denominators. So cosine x times the sine of y in both the numerator and the denominator. So what's that give me? Well, if I do the distributive property here, cosine y over sine y times cosine x sine y, the sine y's cancel, and you end up with the cosine y times the cosine of x, which I'm just going to write that as the cosine of x times the cosine of y minus. Then we're doing the second term in this parentheses by cos x sine y. The cosine x's cancel, and I have sine x sine y. Then we do the denominator. The first term in here, cosine y over sine y, multiplying by cos x sine y. The sine y's cancel, so I have a cosine y times a cosine x, or cos x cos y, plus, when I multiply the second term times this, the cosine x's cancel, and I have sine x sine y. And that's exactly what I have on the left-hand side once I simplify that cosine of x plus y, cosine of x minus y. If you're going to do a formal proof where you would go just work on one side, the next step here is to recognize that This formula, cosine x cosine y minus sine x sine y, is simply the cosine of x plus y, and that the denominator is actually the cosine of x minus y, and you wouldn't have had to have this on that side. So a formal proof, you would start off with the right-hand side, and that would be how it ended. So this is what it would look like. You begin with the problem, prove or verify this identity, then you write proof. You decide which side you're going to work on. I'd start with the right-hand side here, and then I simplify that side. So first I change to cosines and sines, then I multiplied, that's not showing up here, cosine x times sine y by the numerator and the denominator. Then I do the distributive property, and then I note that the numerator really is the cosine of x plus y and the cosine of x minus y, which was what the other side is. QED means that which is to be proved, so this is just a more formal way of doing the proof. Both are valid, so here's how it looked before. This is easier for most people. You just sort of like underline the whole thing, underline underneath the equal sign, then you just simplify one side, but it means you can also work on the other side. The idea is at the very end, whatever's at the bottom on the left, which in this case is the same thing as what you see at the top, is the same thing that you see on the right-hand side of the proof. So we have exactly the same thing on both sides, but you could have, remember, had this piece right here. Oops, a little small. Technical difficulties. There we go. In a more informal proof, so this is actually fine, but you worked on both sides. That's the only difference.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.